Here we go! NieR Automata is finally out at long last, the game whose demo was so good it led to me playing an entire other game. Funny how that goes, huh? Yeah, the demo for this game was so good that I went on to play all the way through NieR on this channel, so check the link in the description if you want to get caught up on the previous game if you missed that. That's a very interesting game. And it's a very bad game in many ways. It's cool for its neat little characters and quirks and commentary on video games in general. It's essentially like a satire of sorts of RPGs in general and their tropes and the dark implications that said tropes generally have on what the player represents for society and stuff like that. Not a very well-made game, though. Like, the part where you have to actually play it with a controller and do stuff like that, that part's not great. Definitely remembered for the other reasons and not for that reason. This one, though, seems like it's going to take care of that, because it's made by Platinum Games. They make fantastic games, except for every now and then. Every now and then they screw up, but judging by the demo that came out a while ago for this one, it seems like this is definitely not one of those cases. This very much looks like it's threatening to become another Bayonetta situation where they put out a fantastic product, and I'm excited. And I just want to see what's going to happen when that developer, with its polish for combat systems and game design, crosses with the other guys that made NieR and the craziness that was the story of that game. Like, this could be a really cool collaboration. This might be one of those games that people talk about at the end of the year. This game does not support autosave. Play the game and find out how to play the game to find out how to save. I've never seen a game say that before, ever. In fact, I've never even seen a game say that it doesn't autosave. Every game warns you that it does autosave, and games that don't autosave just often don't tell you. This one specifically tells us it does not autosave, but then it also is like, I don't know, how do you save? I don't know, freaking play the game, find out. It's a fun surprise. I've never seen it put that way before. Interesting. Ah, we're doing this now, alright. Oh, it's to be used in online functions. Ah, let's do it. Why was it prohibited words, though? You can't use lock-on on higher difficulties? Very hard, you die in one hit. What? Okay. It says it's the most enjoyable difficulty, probably. Interesting. It's a Platinum game, so I think normal is genuinely normal and not secretly easy. And I think hard modes and very hard modes are genuinely meant to be challenge modes in these cases. So let's go with the standard.
Everything that lives is designed to end. We are perpetually trapped in a never-ending spiral of life and death. Is this a curse? Or some kind of punishment? I often think about the god who blessed us with this cryptic puzzle, and wonder if we'll ever have the chance to kill him.
This is Command. Yorha Squadron, come in.
2B here. All units have penetrated the stratosphere. Autopilot systems green across the board.
This is Operator 6-0. All units confirmed.
We've passed the 50-kilometer threshold and are proceeding toward the target.
Understood. Once you reach their anti-air defenses, proceed to manual attack formation. Then destroy the Goliath-class unit by any means necessary and gather what data you can.
Understood.
Ah! 12H down. All units activate manual mode and rely on visuals to evade.
Already engaged. Free movement unlocked.
Origin point of long-range lasers confirmed. Ah! 11B, down. Our HO229 cancelers are ineffective.
Alert. Enemy unit sighted ahead.
Requesting permission to engage.
Permission granted.
Things are immediately weird. We're starting off as a shmup. Immediately?
7E down.
Holy crap. Yeah, don't go giving me crap about them not having emotions as what they are, because they scream when they die. Well, they used to.
Assuming captain's duties.
And so I'm the leader now? That was quick. We're quickly running out of allies. So what's the heavy attack do? Triangle? Makes me spin. Like that, okay. Doesn't seem relevant yet, considering how fast everything dies.
Multiple surrounding enemy air units confirmed. Requesting permission to assume mobile configuration.
Permission granted.
Oh my god. This totally is immediately like the first NieR game, where they commentate and or borrow elements of various other genres. We went from being a monodirectional shooter to being a dual stick shooter immediately, because that game would take its time as like doing a little bit of a Resident Evil, and then it would become a side scroller.
I think
isometric dungeon crawler and so on.
4B down.
2B to operator 6-0. All allied units down. The operation is compromised. Awaiting further orders.
Operator to 2B, we need you to rendezvous with Unit 9S and begin gathering data on the local terrain.
Understood.
Now it's Star Foxy. Okay, sure. Yeah, they're gonna have fun with this. They're gonna have every excuse to go full weird with this for a while. Huh? That was a little worrying. Okay. Huh? Okay. Okay, camera's freaking me out. The rotation of the camera's something to deal with. Oh, hi. Now it's a side-scrolling shooter. Alright. We've immediately used four types of shooters in sequence, although I didn't shoot anybody in the Star Fox camera. I can't remember any shooters that have this camera angle. But I can't remember my name. But I know they exist. Straightforward so far. Triangle still does a weird globe thing, yeah. Oh. Hi. This is neat. I wonder if any... I'm trying to think of if any game in the genre we're parodying right now actually does this, though. Changing gameplay styles and this with such frequency. Triangle. Whoa, that's a sword. That's neat. I stopped shooting at a little globe thing and went and switched to like a whole sword attack. There we go. That's neat. You're kind of compromised at this point. You're facing the wrong way. Took some damage, though.
Alert. Heavy damage standard complex system has been activated. Activating short-range attack gear. Alert. Large enemy group detected.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
My stuff broke. Now I'm sad. Oh my goodness. That is pleasant. Ow. By the way. That's some satisfying animation right there. There we go. It's really satisfying being able to shoot and attack at the same time. So the little pod guy is a clear reference to Vice from the previous game. An attempt to reintegrate the same sort of mechanic. There we go. Because that was a game where you'd go into a facility and fight robots and stuff like that, and you'd have a little character following you around that you would shoot your spells in that game. But in that game, he shot magic, whereas this character shoots just bullets. Every now and then a circle pops up. Let's see if I can trigger one of those correctly. There we go. Bye! I'm sure he's having fun. Trying to grab whatever parts I can find, just in case. Also, her swords float around her. That seems like kind of a big deal. Ah! I keep forgetting I can shoot at the same time.
Enemies destroyed.
Not quite.
That's real big. That's real big. Okay.
Is that our target?
Negative. This enemy is unrelated. Proposal, dispatch it as swiftly as possible.
You don't say.
My bad. I was trying... I don't remember if there's a block button. So I kind of just took that to the face. That's not good for you. Oh, you're gonna be having a bad time now. Neat. There's my dash. There it is. Ah, crap. Ow. Gotta be careful here.
Pod program download complete.
Dodge out of the way. So we now have a new pod program. There we go. So we've gained a laser bombardment attack that has a cooldown to it where we have to worry about whether or not it'll last. There we go. I figured out a better spot to dodge to. We're way better off, clearly. Laser time. It's clear. I think we're clear.
Better make sure he's actually dead next time. That was dangerous, man. You're 2B, right? My name's 9S. I'm here to provide support.
Copy that.
So, was that big old buzzsaw the Goliath you came here to take out?
No, just another defensive system.
Oh, well, I guess we have to find the target then, huh? I've got a flight unit, so I'll take a look around the perimeter.
All right. I'll work my way inside from the ground.
This game is running gloriously so far. Perfect maintained frame rate, flashy everything on the screen, satisfying animations across the board. Look at that. Just everything about how you move and attack. Off to a good start. Ooh, air dash. Oh, double jump. Double jump and then glide, and then air dash. That's interesting that we can hold on to him. Doesn't really slow our descent that much, though. Hi there. Can you come down here, please? I need to have a word with you. Oh, you're alive. Stop that. There we go. Trying to remember to grab what I can. They're a little missable looking. What's that? Iron ore. Oh, that's not a direction to go in. Moment of panic. Hi there. You thought you dodged the combo, but the combo continues for good. We'll have to see what relationship this game has, if any, to the previous game. If it's even existing in the same world, or if it's even, like, I actually don't know yet. We'll see. We're some sort of non-human creature. That's telling already. Because in the previous game, everyone was a replicant. That was the whole point. We're strange, nameless people that go by numbers and fly mechs around and have robot assistants fighting other robots.
To be? Ma'am?
What is it?
I was going to send you the map data I collected earlier.
Do it.
Dash spamming is satisfying for some reason. Probably just because of the ridiculous glide. Oops. There we go. Hi there, friend. Oh, I did not aim that correctly at all. We're now, so we changed perspectives to the aim here, and suddenly I'm aiming on a two-dimensional plane. I'm also moving on a two-dimensional plane for the most part. Up we go. What are you guys hiding over here, huh? Nope. Okay. No. Where are you going, buddy? Alright, well, you do you. You just decide to leave, I guess. Got a broken staircase. Curious, but I think that is mostly backtracking at that point.
Exit confirmed closed.
Hi there.
So open it.
Negative. Nearby enemies are jamming our signal.
Nothing's ever easy.
There we go. That clears them out real fast. Don't know if the stuff disappears, so I'm trying to grab it as soon as I can. There we go. You having a bad time? Come here. I'm trying to reach you in the air. Ow. Watch out. It almost sounds like the Ghost in the Shell soundtrack. Which is a bit of a jump from the previous game soundtrack. Thank you. Whoa, we have company. The enemies themselves are not astonishing. It was just the wave of bullets that were sneaking up on me when I was looking the other way. That was a bit of a surprise. It's one less to deal with. Clear. Just makes short work of everything in the game so far.
You know, ma'am, I'm glad you're here.
Why?
Scanners like me mostly work alone. Scouting out enemy lines and all that. I don't usually get a partner. It's kind of fun.
Emotions are prohibited.
Sorry, ma'am.
And another thing. Stop calling me ma'am.
Huh?
It's unnecessary.
All right, then. 2B it is.
Emotions are prohibited, says the person whose entire squad just screamed as they died. Yeah, no emotions there. This is some beautiful backgrounds. I think it won't let me pick it up because I'm fighting right now. Just clearing that out real quick. Grab the thing. I can't grab the thing. Weird. Any baddies? So you can actually shoot their projectiles, which wipes them out before they can reach you, which is really handy. I can grab that one. Huh. I can climb the ladder, too. And you can dash up the ladder. That comes in handy. Hi there. Bad time for you. Can I pick this up? There you go. Bullets. There we go. Oh, he dodged away. Almost. So interestingly, I do square triangle. Yeah, all those hits come from one triangle press. It's like you decide to finish the combo, so you're gonna finish the combo, damn it. Like it or not. Ah, crap. I'm adjusting my aim poorly. Ow. Come here. Nope. Let's grab what they left. So we're auto using recovery items. There must be a threshold that auto uses them. It's probably pre-built on my character. Let's try pausing. System menu, I think I know what a system menu is. Quests. 2B, level 3. Items, restorative items. Small recovery does 25%, medium does 50%, large does 75%. I have a fair number of them already. Enhancement items. 15% boosts, basically. These are a bunch of the things we're collecting so far. How are we doing on weapons? I have 5% of all the ones in the game, apparently. We have our bare fist for combat bracers. I think that we already have swords. Yeah, I think we have everything equipped already in our current weapon set. Pod programs, that's the Gatling thing that they use. Oh, this looks like it could be a thing. Okay. An android central system. Removal means death. Display the player's hit point gauge. Remove. Yep, there goes my hit points. You can uninstall your basic interface in this game. That's interesting. That's real interesting. Alright. Customize. All chips. What's not currently equipped? Let's re-equip the hit points. Why don't we? So it looks like... Okay. You can see this meter in the middle of the screen. The dark brown area is all the stuff that I have equipped right now. So that's interesting. Auto-use item plus one. Okay, so all these brown things are HUD elements. And so I can uninstall whatever HUD elements I want to, if I choose. Except this one, that kills me. So if I want to kill myself, apparently I can. This one, though, is the auto-use of item. When my hit points drop below 30%, I automatically use a healing item, and apparently it heals 15% more than normal. And then there's a whole bunch of auto things for easy mode. Auto-attack? Auto-fire? Auto-evade? Auto-program? Auto-swipe? Wow. They genuinely made easy mode easy, I suppose. Interesting. Well, we know that stuff exists now. Support? That's the auto-use... Yeah, that's the auto-use item. Unit data tutorials. I think we're good to go for now. Just taking a look around at our stuff. Can I open this guy?
This elevator's controls are locked and cannot be used.
Yeah, but what if I wanna? Have you considered that?
This place sure is big.
I guess humans used to use it as a weapons factory. But now it's just crawling with machines. The enemy seems to have repurposed the facility to increase their overall machine production.
So if we don't destroy it, they'll just keep coming.
What if the villain of this game is that Anakin Skywalker kid from the previous NieR game? He was scavenging from a weapons facility, and he modified weapons, but then his brother died tragically, so he turned evil, or at least very angry. Ow. My bad. Okay, let's try to clear out the dots if I can. There we go. It clears things out a little bit. I kind of wish I could auto-pick up items. Unless there's some sort of inventory cap. But I don't think there is. It'd be nice to be able to pick up stuff like copper just by running over it, basically. I think you mostly have to hit circle, though. Let's try to do that finisher again, if I can. There we go. Kick! I just like having the option. What's great about the dash is that you can change direction mid-dash. Like, it's really satisfying to change directions like that.
What?
It's just accessing random, nonsensical data from the old world. There's no actual meaning behind anything machines do.
Bye. So right now the intercom's just sort of shouting out lines. I wish it was subtitled, because it's kind of hard to make out when it's with the muffling. But what if it's not? What if it's not nonsensical at all? Ow. Got one. At this distance, it's slightly harder to tell what is going on with my interface. Like, the skill notifier covers so much that it's actually a little hard to tell where I'm swinging. But I don't think the game has major demands to place on me right now, so it's not that big of a deal. I hope these things don't disappear. Because NieR was jam-packed with enemies that would drop useful items, and then the items would often disappear in the middle of the fight. Which got a little frustrating. Up we go. Hi there. Okay. Kind of missed my chance a little bit. Made up for it. That is a hell of a strong beam attack right there. Kind of does the majority of the work for me. Huh? Missed the ladder. Not that it matters. Yeah, these elevators are looking really familiar, actually.
This elevator's controls are locked and cannot be used.
I wonder if this is supposed to be the same location or a similar one.
Alert. Bulletproof apparatus detected on enemies. Close range combat is advised.
I know.
Because the previous game had a weapons facility that was defunct and taken over by machines. And it itself, ow. And that place was full of stuff like this. Big circular rooms connected by catwalks with, you know, factory elevators. Ow, ow. My bad. Okay, I gotta do this real quick. Just so I don't make a fool of myself too much. Let's just double check. There isn't, is there? Yeah, there's an evade. I don't think there's a dot, block? Okay. That's fine. I just wanted to make sure I wasn't making a fool of myself by completely forgetting about the existing blocking mechanic or something. Watch out. Guy seems mad at me. He's got like a charge-up punch. There we go. I did a last-second dodge and it was like a teleport. That's the satisfying part. There we go. Bad time for you. Much better. Yeah, that's what I should be doing is the invincibility frame dodge. That was a good lineup. That worked out for me. Anyone else? Oh yes, the answer's yes. Crap. I was half sarcastic, but no, there was totally more enemies and they're all coming my way. Bye. Okay. I can make do with this. Gotcha. Anyone else? I think that's all the pieces at the very least. Our sword's taller than we are. It's kind of amazing.
We surveyed the entire factory, but couldn't find anything resembling our target.
Maybe they, I don't know, moved it somewhere?
So we're going from a factory to like an oil rig?
Is that? Nope.
You mean the birds? Yeah, there's more plants and animals here than there used to be. Probably because the environment's changed.
So we are seeing signs of actual life on this place. Is this a dead end? Oh, here we go. Open up. So we're getting a bunch of ore items and a bunch of healing items. Anything down there? No. Oh, wait. Sorry. Almost missed this chest here. Oh, it has a lock on it. Do they all have those? Apparently so. I think I'm just kicking the lock off. Hard boots. Still though, fighting in heels. I guess she can practically fly, so I guess it doesn't make that much of a difference, does it? Wow, there's actually a lot stashed around here. You hiding things over here? No. Nope, invisible wall. Can't go that way. Well, this is dauntingly huge.
There should be another facility across that bridge. It's a bit of a hike, but should we check it out? It's not like command to get a location wrong. I guess even they get bad intel from time to time, huh?
I wouldn't bet on that.
Alert. High power jamming detected. No response from long-range communication. locations.
Doesn't matter. I'll just take him out.
Oh, I nearly forgot. Come over here, I want to hit you with my sword. There we go. Just in time. There we go. Yeah, basically just hold down left trigger and L2 and R1 at all times. So I'm always locked on and shooting. No matter what the fate of the- no matter what else is going on in the fight, basically. That was a mistake. I was like, I'm gonna totally go for a hit. Nope. It's a bad time to try to attack. That's a real bad time to try to attack. Am I dead? I died. Whoops. The Aura Force was annihilated. Earth went on to become a paradise for the machines. What? What was that? The credits just rolled. Well, let's try this again. So by the way, you die, you start the entire level over. So let's try not to do that again. Although I'm not sure what happened. I guess what must have happened is that I just smeared my face up into the blender so hard and so stupidly that I managed to die even though the game automatically uses healing items until you run out, and I was not out of healing items. There must be a cooldown period that's very short. And I managed to take this consecutive hits so fast that it wasn't ready yet. So let's try not to be stupid again, if I can avoid it. No promises. But, I'm amused by the fact that I died because I've played this level already in the demo, which I've also uploaded, and, did not die. So I had no idea that dying would restart the entire mission. I might have been a little bit more careful. I was kind of fooling around. But that's a good reason to be more careful, is the revelation that it's gonna make you start the whole mission over. Can I attack these or not?
Is that?
Target enemy detected.
Oh my god, the level I was just on woke up! So I was standing on that when we looked at the birds a moment ago. Apparently he wasn't a fan. Just guessing. Right now the best I think I can do is just shoot back. And hope at the very least my shots will deflect his shots. But only the ones that aren't dark. Oh, what? Where did you just shoot? Oh, he's locking onto something down there now. Whoops. That wasn't the intention. Oh, crap, that one surprised me. Gotcha. I think I'm making contact there. Not much damage, though. Hook! Holy crap. Oh, weird, when I'm knocked over, it just pauses instead of letting me heal. I don't fully trust my auto-heal right now, so let's use one of these real quick. I'll try not to die as much as I just was. Whoops. Working on those headshots if I can. Ah!
To me!
What's your status?
This is the target. I'm going to destroy it.
Right. I'll provide support.
Ah, crap. Man, getting through these levels without taking a single hit, that takes some practice.
Alert.
Kudos. Good job if you do that.
Proposal. Evade.
I would like to politely suggest that you run away.
Blink. I am not damaging this thing, basically. Oh, I thought I hit the evade button. That's my proper chance to do damage. Just trying to stay on top of that so we don't have a repeat of before. I do feel like I'm taking more damage than I was in the demo, but maybe I just don't remember the demo very well. He's taking damage so slowly that it actually feels like he's healing. Okay, that time I definitely hit evade. I guess I'm supposed to just run away from the entire attack.
Packing in.
I'm going after him.
What was that about no emotions, 2B? That sounded like an exclamation to me.
Negative. Communications have been jammed.
How weird is it that this robot's on him? Come back here, I'm trying to murder you. There we go. Oops, I missed that. Hey there. Whoa. Some of these attacks are kind of awesome. Yeah, that's how I climb ladders every day. Especially the flip at the end. It's great for my figure.
9S!
Oh, thanks for the help, robot. My pod shot nothing. Shot the open air, basically, far away from the fight. Really nailed it. Okay, that could have been better, but sure. I'm gonna have to get better at aiming that.
9S. I have to repair him. Pod, get me staunching gel and logic virus vaccines, then access the-
Inadvisable. The subject's vital signs are too poor to attempt field repair.
Shut up! Just do what I say!
2B, just go.
You shut up too!
We're soldiers. We take pride in our service.
HO-229 flight unit, command 677 received. Usage rights transferred from 9S to 2B. Requesting acknowledgement.
Please.
All right.
Screaming something at me. Hard to make out. So in one level we did four different types of shooter game. Oh, now it's shooting. Now we can hear it. It's just saying kill over and over again. So we did multiple types of shooters in a row. Then we did a ground-based like JRPG action RPG thing. Now we're fighting in a mech.
2B. a weakness in the target, hacking in to provide support.
Trying to evade because he took a bad hit back there.
To be the control on the enemy's upper arm, use your pod. Should be able to take it over.
I told you to shut up!
I've almost gotten down without that even. I almost don't need special powers. Oh.
Control of upper arm seized from enemy unit. Marking weak point. Got it.
That's a big old beam.
Affirmative. Infiltrating enemy subunit. Behavior table adjusted. Balance controls overridden. Enemy unit subjugation complete.
Falcon! Oh wow, there goes a lot of his health. Just around the spot. Okay, effective.
You just die already!
Talk about bringing the battle to them. Ought to be.
Contact command. Request assistance.
No. It doesn't look like that's going to be necessary.
Oh, great.
Imagine that this is going to end well. The black box. It's ready.
Right.
Requesting destruction of enemy hostiles via black box reaction.
Request accepted.
Doobie, it was an honor to fight with you. Truly.
The honor was mine.